Ozone therapy is the closest thing we have today to a miracle drug.
In this video, I will go over several points. What ozone therapy is, quick ozone setup in the home, how you can use ozone in the home, and lastly, prove to you that ozone really works. Ozone therapy does four main things. First, it destroys bacteria, viruses, yeasts, fungi, and protozoa without hurting us when it's done right. Second, it signals and activates the immune system. Ozone is actually part of our natural immune system. When it activates our immune system, it also includes tumor-destroying proteins. Third, it increases the energy production from our red blood cells so we have more energy. Fourth, it floods the body with readily available oxygen. Ozone is utilized in three basic forms, each having its own advantages and disadvantages. First is ozone gas. Ozone is in its most potent and strong form when it is a gas. The disadvantage of ozone gas is that it's difficult to contain in one location, and free ozone gas irritates the eyes and respiratory system and can cause problems. Second is the oil form. The benefit of oil is that all the ozone is contained within the oil and whatever the oil is in contact with. Another advantage is oil keeps the ozone for long periods of time, and it doesn't dissipate as quick as ozone gas or ozonated water. Because of its ability to keep ozone in contact with one area for long periods of time, it is an excellent topical antibiotic, antifungal, and antiviral. If ozone oil is your only desired use of ozone, I would just purchase it from the website I have linked to in this video instead of buying the whole ozone setup. Ozonated water is the least potent of the three forms and only keeps for about 30 minutes when it's cold. But still, ozonated water has some very practical uses where the other forms cannot be used. This is my basic ozone setup you see here. It starts with an oxygen source. Our air actually has a low concentration of oxygen, so we need an oxygen source. I use an oxygen concentrator that takes the air and makes the oxygen content about 95%. You can use an oxygen tank as well that delivers 99% oxygen, which is a little bit higher, but an oxygen tank costs you every time it runs out, and they can be difficult to come by and to refill. Next, you'll need Teflon tubing and lure locks to connect each device in the setup. The Teflon tubing will not break down to ozone. Speaking of airflow, the slower the air moves through the ozone generator, the more concentrated and potent the generator can make the ozone. So it's not advantageous to have very fast moving air. My oxygen concentrator flow is 1 to 5 liters per minute, which is too fast of airflow for a good ozone concentration. So I run the oxygen through a pediatric flow meter. This can take the oxygen flow rate to 1/16 liter per minute, and even slightly lower, which is optimal for ozone concentration. If you decided to use an oxygen tank, you will also need to purchase a tank flow regulator to bring it down to low speeds as well. Now that the oxygen is concentrated and moving slowly, it is delivered to the ozone generator. Once the air travels through the ozone generator, it enters into a tube within the generator that hits the oxygen with high energy and converts the oxygen to ozone. Regular oxygen is 2 oxygen molecules bonded together. Ozone is 3 oxygen molecules bonded together. Once again, the slower the oxygen flow, the better for a high concentration of ozone. I will link to the best ozone generators below. Be careful. This ozone is very strong stuff. To prevent yourself from breathing the ozone, you can always run the excess ozone through activated carbon, which destroys the ozone. Then, as a precaution, always work under a vent or next to a running vacuum or at least near a fan. If not, ozone builds up in the air and can really irritate your lungs. This is very serious. If this does happen, it's good to have a pack of powdered vitamin C handy to swallow dry to react with the excess ozone and hopefully lessen the effects of breathing in ozone. I will link to every product I mention in the description below. To ozonate water, you need a glass flask and a bowl of ice or something to keep it cold, and a water bubbler. Don't forget to use distilled water. I use an old refrigerator to keep my ozonated water cold. I destroy the excess ozone through activated carbon and a vent. Ozone water has many practical uses. Ozone water can be used with a water pick to fight gum disease and cavities. You can wipe your kitchen counters with ozone water to disinfect them. To wash your fruits or ozonate your meats, which is how meat companies sterilize meat, place it in water hooked up to an ozone bubbler with good ventilation. Ozone water is a great way to ensure that your water is sterile, like for emergency preparedness. To ozonate oil, you can use plenty of types of oil. Some are better than others, though. For beginners, I would just use virgin olive oil. It's cheap and really good. You will also need a glass container, a bubbler, and a lot of time. It can take a week or longer to ozonate oil. In fact, I recommend just buying ozonated oils from one of the links below instead of making yourself. You can apply ozone oil to herpes, warts, and other viral lesions. It can prevent open wounds from infection. It can eliminate jock itch or toenail fungus. When in soap form, it can be used to fight acne. For colds, you can just breathe oil-filtered ozone gas, which kills infections in the sinuses. Or, like mentioned before, freeze ozonated water and suck on the ozonated ice to get rid of throat infections. You can also just drink or gargle the ozonated water. The uses of ozone gas are plentiful. It can be used to do ozone insufflations, ozone saunas, and autohemotherapy, which is blood ozonation. These deliver ozone to the whole body to fight things like STDs, MS, Lyme disease, and some cancers, and many other diseases, though further research is needed. To do ear insufflations, I use an ear scope that I made, but better ones can be bought online. I set up a fan that blows to a vent for excess ozone that escapes. You can also do rectal or vaginal insufflations, which obviously I won't go over here. To do an ozone sauna, you have to purchase an ozone steam cabinet and hook it up to the ozone generator. Ozone injections are a great way to deliver ozone to subcutaneous parts of the body. Once below your dermal level, the gases are able to dissipate into surrounding tissues that are possibly infected, like a degenerating joint or dental abscess. There are syringe delivery systems that you can purchase, but I just quickly connect the syringe to the hose, and once I remove it, quickly cap it off with the needle. Medical professionals are normally the only people that can deliver ozone this way. Ozone gas can get rid of smoking odors, like in a car. To deliver ozone to a specific area, use an ozone cup. An oxygen mask you'll have to modify makes a great ozone cup because it fits over uneven surfaces. There are more formal ozone gas cups as well. This is good for skin infections like what I had. There are definitely more uses for ozone, but these are the basics. Equipment for all this is linked to in the description below. Proof that ozone works. There are plenty of scientific articles proving that ozone works, like these. There's good evidence out there that ozone therapy have been able to help lower viral loads from STDs, also get rid of diseases like multiple sclerosis, and help keep cancers under control. Here's a testimonial of a woman defeating MS with ozone therapy.
Actually, now I'll tell you that I function 100% normal. There's no residue of multiple sclerosis in my life whatsoever. And the only thing I did differently was ozone.
Bacteria cell structure is close to the structure of this latex glove. And see how it obliterates the latex glove, yet I am left unharmed. This is what happens when ozone hits bacteria within your body. Look at the bacteria-infested water react to ozone. Pay attention to the film on top of the water. As the dying bacteria collapses, the film on top of the water moves inward. If it were just because of the air blowing, the film would move away from the air source. Tesla, the famous scientist, would breathe ozone all the time, and he lived to a very old age for his day. But let me be clear, I'm not an advocate for breathing ozone every day. Look at this small experiment I did with petri dishes that grow E. coli.
When I gas the bacteria sample or wash the apple with ozonated water, it leaves no traces of E. coli.
Remember, it is up to you to know the laws pertaining to ozone in your area and country before you use and purchase ozone equipment. Ozone is the Earth's most natural and powerful disinfectant. What I have gone over is how we can harness its strength and ability. Spread the word about ozone by liking this video, and please subscribe.